Hello children, welcome to Anil Tech Guru. In this video, we are going to discuss about various excretory organs and in excretory system. We know that our body is a cellular factory. We cannot produce without generating any waste. This waste has to send out from our body within intervals. To send out this excretory materials, we need excretory organs. So, different organisms used various strategies in excretion. In unicellular organism, specific excretory organs are absent. They remove waste products by simple diffusion from the body surface into surrounding waste. Multicellular organisms possess different excretory organs for removal of waste materials from the body. Structure and functional complexity of excretory organs increase from sponges to human beings. This is true. So, the complexity of excretory organs is increasing from sponges to human beings. Okay, let us discuss how the complexity is increasing. In phylum protozoa, the main excretion take place through the body surface through the process of osmosis in the surrounding water. They have osmoregulatory organelles called contractile vacuoles. For example, we can observe this type of excretion in amoeba. In the phylum of Porifera and Coelenterata, do not have specific excretory organs. They use water bottles almost all their cells. For example, sponges and hydra belongs to Porifera and Coelenterates. In the same way, in the phylum of Platyhelminthes, we can observe excretory organs for the first time. In this phylum, the flame cells are the excretory organs. In this Platyhelminthes, for example, Planaria. So these are the flame cells. So they are the excretory organs in platyworms. At the same time, in the phylum of Nematyhelminthes or Nematoda, rennet cells are the excretory organs. We can observe these kind of cells in roundworms, pinworms, etc. So almost all in this phylum belongs to parasites. In the phylum of annelids, nephridias are the excretory organs. We can observe nephridias in earthworm, leech, and some other organisms which belongs to annelids. So this is the nephridia, the structure of nephridia. In the phylum of Arthropoda, it is the biggest phylum in the animal kingdom. We can observe the green glands or Malpighian tubules as a excretory organelles. So this type of Malpighian tubules in cockroach and most of the insects, so we can observe as a excretory organs. So right, at the same time, in the phylum of Mollusca, metanephridias are the excretory organs. We can observe the metanephridias in snails. So some of the snails which belongs to Mollusca, those organism shows metanephridia as a excretory organs. In the phylum of Echinodermata, they use excretory system as a water vascular system. So water vascular system is the excretory organs in the Echinodermata. We can observe this kind of system in starfish, sea urchin, other type of organisms which belongs to Echinodermata. In higher classes, in higher phylums like reptiles, aves, mammals, kidneys are the excretory organs. Obviously, we know that kidneys are the excretory organs in human beings, elephants, vultures, birds, at the same time giraffes. So which animals are belongs to reptiles, aves and mammals? So this is the information about excretory organs. Thank you friends. Please subscribe Anil Tech Guru. Please thank you. Please share it.